Next on Extreme Close-Up, Chris Isaak's Wicked Thrifty Game.
I never dreamed that I'd meet somebody like you. I never dreamed that I'd love somebody like you.
Chris Isaak is somewhat of a contradiction. In spite of his movie star looks and his sexy singing style, Chris has a rather silly personality.
What I want to do is go right back into the kitchen and we'll check for roast infestation there. Yeah. Kenny, you'll check right around the cooking
grease
areas.
Grease backup is always bad, yeah.
Grease backup is our basic problem.
Okay, let's go.
Let's go.
The California native spent Isaac stayed closer to home while recording his latest album, San Francisco Days. This fourth album includes his trademark melancholy music and surprisingly a few upbeat songs.
And you can do to stop me.
Well, yeah, as you can see, I'm here at the Valley Thrift Store in the lovely, beautiful Sun Valley, California. Now, I'm here at the thrift store because Chris Isaak is inside. I know, why am I doing an interview here? Well, you see, he likes thrift stores, and I like to tailor-make my interviews, as always. And I'm going to go inside, meet him, check him out, and I'm going to shop, too. What can I say?
They don't realize that love can sometimes bring.
Chris, you're creating a crowd here. How you doing?
Pretty good. How you doing?
Nice to see you.
You know Kenny?
Hey, Kenny,
hey,
yeah.
Hey, how's it going?
How you doing?
Do you remember him?
Well, I met him about...
We're old pals.
You know, a long time ago.
A long time ago, I think it was 1978, he fixed your transmission on Pinto.
Was that?
That was me, in that Pinto.
I was saying, your hair was longer,
yeah,
though.
Yeah, you had a pink Pinto station wagon.
I still have it.
Stock.
And you kept it stock, right?
Yeah, okay, you know.
All right.
I still have it.
Yeah.
I still have it. Oh, wow. That's pretty good. I remember that. So you are out here just finishing up San Francisco Days, huh?
Yeah, we finished up with this record, and now we're going out and trying to sell them door to door.
And you know, in fact, I'm going to go along with you. Did they tell you?
I like that idea.
Okay, good, because you know I've got some experience in retail.
You don't need experience.
See?
You just come with us.
There you go. Now, you see, but I noticed that, we're like making these people real nervous back there.
Mice.
They said, ooh, muy guapo, muy guapo.
Really?
You know what that means?
Yeah.
They said you look...
It means they like Kenny.
So I noticed what is it, accept the new girl?
Muy guapo. It's like,
yeah, man.
You know, we speak Spanish is like a second language to us.
I know how to speak Spanish too.
Do you really?
Yeah.
Can we sing something in Spanish?
Go right ahead.
You wanna get somebody? We'll dedicate it to somebody.
Okay.
Okay? This one is Kenny, what's it? Bring somebody over there. Come on.
Oh my God.
Come on.
Come on. Don't be shy. Come on over.
Now this one, you speak Spanish?
Yes, I do.
Okay.
Come on in.
This one is called, Kenny will help out too. This one's called La Tumba Será el Final.
Uh-huh.
You know what that
means? You know it.
Kenny speaks Spanish too, he told me. Kenny, what does that mean? La Tumba Será el Final.
I dig Anna.
Close enough.
Yeah.
Is there a sing?
Nuestro amor es tan grande como no habrá jamás. Juntos caminaremos hasta la muerte. Y aunque el mundo se aponga,
hey, I need some
Here comes the good part. Hang in there.
La tumba será el final. Ahí será la separación. Y hasta en la tumba te sigo el mando si quiere Dios.
Go the whole way.
Go.
Miente y te segura que no te quiero.
Here's the part I like. I give it hell.
Go ahead.
Solamente a mi madre la quería más que a ti.
How's my pronunciation?
Great.
Ella que nos bendice de aire del cielo. Me lo dijo en un sueño.
Five string guitar.
Que serás para mí.
And para tú.
La tumba será el final.
Dig me.
Ahí será la separación.
Y hasta en la tumba te sigo amando, si quiere Dios.
We better wrap it up, I'm running out of string.
Y hasta en la tumba te sigo amando. Si quiere Dios.
So, you know, like in the studio, is it better if you're in love or maybe going in there with a broken heart to get the emotion?
No, I don't think it's better to go in there with a broken heart. You want to go in there, you know, in a good mood, ready to work. Going in there down and out, it's not a good way to go and going to work.
But you know, I mean, it, maybe
I'm
the
happy
emotion
though. When I'm going in there, I got a recording contract. I'm happy to go to work. It's like, what kind of, that's fun, you know?
Now, what about your new album, San Francisco Days?
I need my other guitar.
You need your other guitar?
Yeah.
Should we get it?
We can get somebody to get it for you.
Yeah, it's in the trunk.
That's fine. But now, back to this love thing here. You know, I mentioned to some people that I was going to interview you, and several of them said he's a heartthrob, a heartbreaker. Is that true?
Ooh, now if you just hold my hand while you say it.
But you...
No,
you,
I don't think.
You, no? You don't think you're a heartbreaker?
I haven't been breaking any hearts.
Excuse me.
Hey.
Here's
I thought you were taking
guitar
off the... I
How many
gonna...
guitars do you carry around in your trunk anyway?
Well, this is like... This is a spare. I had this one with me. The only thing about this is everything kind of sounds like Hawaiian.
Oh, yeah.
Which is a good thing. Am I right, Kenny?
You couldn't have done that Spanish song with this one.
Dude, Leilani.
Sweet Leilani. Heavenly flower, I dreamt of paradise for two. My lovely Leilani, oh, you are my paradise completed. You are my dream come true. Sweet Leilani, heavenly flower, tropic skies are jealous while they shine. I think they're jealous of your blue eyes. Jealous because you're mine.
So I guess a witness is for myself. You do have that Roy Orbison thing happening there.
Steal a little falsetto wherever I can get it. And it's fun.
It's really working because you met him.
But I think the Hawaiians had it before even Roy.
Yeah.
But you met him before you were famous.
Yes, I did.
And he gave you some tips or some advice?
He was, you know, be serious, he was really, really nice. Kenny and I, we met him and we got to sing with him. And I went to his house and I got to sing with him over his house, just he and I sitting around. And one time I said to him, I said, you know, because he wrote so many hits and cool songs and stuff, I said, I wrote these songs, but I don't know if they're really hits. I don't know if I write hits. Because I never had really a hit when I was talking to him. And he said, oh, yeah. He goes, you write hits. You just don't know it yet.
By the way, you didn't bring me an instrument. What's the problem?
You play?
Come on. Give me something. A cowbell, a tambourine, or something.
Well,
what do we got around
improvise
here?
And you play this.
I'll play this. And by the way, when Extreme Close Up comes back, we're going to get more of this thrifty concert here. We're talking free. We're at a thrift shop, so don't go away. Hit it, guys.
Pretty good.
I never dreamed that I
audience right behind us. They're here, man.
Hey, guys. Did you like that? Te gusta? they're like, they're shut up, Arthel.
They're going, don't any Whitney Houston?
Yeah, come right. You understand, you sing yourself or play yourself to sleep at night.
Yeah. Usually I cry myself. Yeah, usually I play in bed a lot of times at the end of the day. And I got this little guitar, so it's good. There's plenty of room, you know. It's good. You just lay in bed and play.
Is that when you write, maybe?
Yeah, I write a lot of times late at night because I'm nervous during the day. And by the end of the day, you get tired enough that you don't really feel so nervous. And there comes like a little bit moment between nervous and dead tired. Right about then, I can write.
Now, I understand that even though, I mean, you're so relaxed, of course, doing this in front of these guys and here at the thrift shop, but I understand that you get a little nervous before you go on stage, so you and your band get together and do a little huddle.
Yeah, we always get, you always get a little bit nervous before you go on stage because then you're getting paid.
Right.
We're not nervous today, right, Kenny?
Nah, what the heck, you know? Nobody can ask for their money back today. Before you go on stage, you're always a little nervous, but it's good, you know? When I first started playing, I remember I was watching the other bands and everybody was drinking beers before they went on to, like they said, to loosen up or whatever. And I thought, if I drink a beer tonight to loosen up, then I'll drink a beer every night and I want to be doing this for a long time. So I didn't, and I went on stage nervous, but it kind of helped, you know? You go on with nervous energy.
Right.
And it helps out.
Seeing that you play yourself to sleep at night and do your music at bedtime, is there anyone there, special person in your life at this point, who gets to hear this?
Well, lately, this year, I've only been home about probably 10 or 12 days. Since September, I've been home about 12 days. So I've been traveling so much. I mean, a lot of the time I spent was in, like, Bhutan and Kathmandu in a Buddhist Tibetan monastery. And there's, you know, I didn't really want to have any of the monks come over to my house while I played, you know what I mean? Or like, you're in a monastery, hey guys, come in here, I'm going to sing before I go to bed. Nah, maybe not. So it's been kind of like, I've been on my own pretty much this year.
Because you've been on the road, not only just with your music, you were doing a movie.
Yeah.
That's
coming
out.
Shooting over there, we did a film called Little Buddha with Bertolucci. And that was strange. It's strange, you know, like, because they're so different. Different lifestyles, musicians and Tibetan monks. You would think, hey, these people are virtually identical, but let me tell you, there's a lot of differences there. Although one thing in common, which is not, this is not a joke, what do you think that the Tibetan monks want to talk to me about? Or I would, you know, I talk to them, I talk about Buddhism or living up in the mountains here by yourself. Every time they would talk, they'd say, so, like in California, you know a lot of blonde girls?
No.
Or, I mean, they all wanted to talk about girls. I'm not kidding.
I tell you what we're going to do. We're going to take you, Mr. Isaak, on a wicked shopping game when Extreme Close-Up comes back.
Anything I can get in the basket within 3 minutes is mine.
Welcome back to Extreme Close-Up, E's half-hour interview show with Chris Isaak.
Now, how do you attack a thrift store? You got to tell me that. Where do you go first?
Usually I go to the women's section. Usually I just go right over here where the musical instruments, tie clips, things like that are.
Well, here are some tie clips.
Tie clips right here.
Okay.
Check them out.
Now, what's too much in a thrift store? You know, like how much is too much, by the way, in a thrift shop?
Usually anything more than like 50 cents I balk at.
Uh-oh, we better take this tray away.
So tell me what you like here.
I like that. That's kind of cool.
That is nice. That's really nice, huh? Oh, look, and a
See? It's a living tie clip. This is one actually made a lot of these. It's
Check
a living,
it out.
Moving one. Watch, don't let him head towards your hand. He'll jump off there.
It's a spider.
He actually lives there. That's his home.
That's nice, Chris.
And you take that and you give that to someone, that grows, actually, and it kind of weaves a shirt around
the
tie clip.
And it grows on you. I hear there's some other stuff in the back that you might be interested in, like records.
I thought you were going to say handguns.
Eight-track tapes.
Eight-tracks,
check
like.
Them out?
Yeah, you know, my record's coming out on 8-track.
Let's go check it out.
Let's go.
But you like thrift shops because I understand your mom likes them, or you went to them when you were a little boy. Huh?
Constantly. I know my way around. Let's get out of the women's stuff and get over the good stuff.
No, because I hear you like to get the women's stuff anyway.
Yeah, somebody's been talking.
Yeah, I heard about this. Oh, wait, here. This is you.
Kenny,
This is you.
Wait just a second, I'm sorry.
Here you go.
Kenny, put that back.
Kenny's looking at pumps.
I told him, no pumps, open-toed wedgies. A guy with his figure, what the hell? Put that away.
That's you. Look, here we are. Refrigerator, rockin' zoo.
They told me you were taking me to a fancy restaurant.
This is after I'm taking you. All right, anything here that tickles your fancy?
Oh, yeah.
Here you go.
I dig this big time.
The Mormon Tabernacle Choir.
You can't have enough of this around the house, you know? I mean, sometimes things get tough and a little inspirational music can just do the trick. What else have we got in here?
Uh-huh.
Any cream?
Check it out, Urban Cowboy. But this is good, because look, you have Jimmy Buffett on there, Bonnie Raitt. Jerry Vale.
Jerry Vale.
He's got the taste. Yeah.
Is he on? Hey, you know something? You would like this.
The Brothers Four. Are you going to get this for me?
This is white people kind of like opening up their soul.
Okay. So you're going to buy this for me and explain it to me?
I don't think I could explain it. I dig it.
You never told me. I asked you really, how much is too much in the thrift shop?
Wow, I actually would get this one. That's pretty cool.
Tennessee Ernie Ford pins? Yeah.
Tennessee Ernie Ford is pretty cool. You know, he lived near, in San Francisco. He just passed away like about a year or so ago. 16 tons, you know, 16 tons,
right? You like gospel? You like hymns and everything?
I like Tennessee Ernie Ford. I mean, he's pretty cool. They got a lot of good stuff in here. Kenny.
Let's go over there.
Why? He's getting the good stuff.
Here you go, the Singing Centurions. Here. I want to get this for you. In Nashville. See, you like country and western.
Can you see her? Can you get a close-up on her?
It's your idea of a woman.
Actually, I like the hairstyles, you know? This is the look, Kenny.
So,
a woman like that, she knows here's what goes into sausage.
Arthel, here's Ode to Billy Joe.
Here you go. Frank Sinatra.
Hey, look. Let's put him right here, and it'll look like a little tiny Frank Sinatra is...
Over my shoulder.
I did it my way. Oh, I think we worked this for all it's worth. Let's get out of here.
Go.
Come on.
So, I tell you what. We're going to go back, sit back where we were, and I want to find out about your daydreams.
Let me tell you all about my daydreams. It's a long, slow story.
Welcome back to Extreme Close-Up, E's half-hour interview show with Chris Isaak.
Can I show you my favorite thing in here?
Sure.
All right, it's right over here. See, now I'm liking this lamp here with the fruit inside.
Oh, wow.
I'm liking that.
That's wonderful.
You know, you and I get along, I could tell.
Because you like that too, don't you?
Because, you know, you and I could decorate the house, you know, and we wouldn't have to have company.
See? There you go.
We wouldn't have company.
Nobody would come by.
That lamp would keep them away.
But you know, that's nice, though. I like that. Now, you see, you are still, though, not affected by anything, it seems like. So how do you maintain the focus and not get distracted by material things that you can obviously have?
I maintain my focus through Zen chanting. I don't know what focus. I'm focused. I work every day. How can you get unfocused? You know, just hang out, work.
Yeah. Now, see, I understand that when you were a little boy, you said that your dreams, or this whole idea of being a successful singer, was just part of your daydreams. So,
yeah.
What do you daydream about these days?
I don't know. Sometimes if I'm traveling a lot, I think about like just laying on my couch and watching TV. That's like pretty boring, but it's like if you're traveling every day and stuff, you know, kind of miss going home. I haven't been home in like since September hardly. But I mean, I'm pretty much doing everything I wanted to do. So I'm just hoping I stay healthy so I can keep doing it. It's fun.
Hey, Chris.
Okay.
Say goodbye.
Au revoir. That's French.
Bye.
Chris and I are going to buy this for Arthel. She said this is her favorite thing in the whole store.
I think I'm just going to get this.
That's for your friend who collects these.
Well, actually, you know, I needed one of these because I had one, and the one I had just about wore out. And it's hard to get them on the road.
You know who this is?
Yeah, I think it's Andre the Giant.
No, actually, that's Randy Savage, Macho Man.
No, it isn't.
Chris and I, you know, we had such
a
great
God.
Time.
Yeah.
They're going to find a lamp. Yeah. You guys are going to spend $3.95 in a lamp for me? Oh, man.
But wait a minute, something you didn't see.
What?
It has a green light bulb.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, baby.
Take the tag off so she won't know.
Thank you very much. And of course, this is guaranteed for life. Take the tag off. It's a gift.
Hello.
Thanks.